Hey guys, I just wanted to take this time right now at the beginning of the vlog before we go any further to let you guys know that we are now moving into a whole nother era of the vlog. There is going to be new editing. Nothing happened between me and Walker. We're just moving on to different projects, and I wanted to start using someone else for the editing to maybe give a different feel for this next year of the vlogs. I seriously debated maybe even quitting doing the vlogs, but I realized that I cherish and have a lot of memories through these that I didn't particularly think about taking before, and that means a lot to me. So I'm going to continue to keep doing the vlogs because I also think you guys find some sort of entertainment in it. With that being said, there's going to be a whole lot of new changes this whole next year for the vlog. I am going to be trying to run bi-monthly, which means I'll be putting out 2 vlogs a month now, and that way it'll keep your guys' attention and maybe the viewership up. But I'm excited for the changes. I'm going to do some vlogs throughout the week instead of just on the weekends on my wrestling trip, you know, peel back the curtain a little bit and let you guys look into my life a little bit deeper. I'm not the most exciting guy on the planet, but I am relatable in a lot of senses, and hey, maybe it'll help my other ventures like gaming or, you know, like the clothing line, Spinebuster clothing I just started with Kinzer. So, you know, there's always an avenue to get the success that you want, and that's kind of where my head's at. So I'm excited for what this next year of the vlog brings, and I can't wait to get it started. Let's kick it. Okay, a lot of changes, a lot of new things for the spotlight sessions. It is September 9th. The 1 year anniversary was last month for the vlog. So that means we got brand new stuff going on. We got a new editor, new intros, new transitions, new fun stuff. I didn't wrestle the first week of September, so that's why we're starting kind of almost in the middle of the month. I took a very much needed 2 weeks off. Not that I did it out of wanting to, just not very many shows going on, surprisingly enough. But we are on our way to Levelin, Texas for BCW Live to Rise, I believe is the name of it. Live to Rise, that wouldn't make sense. It's Live to Rise. But yeah, we got a solid 6 hour drive there, 6 hour drive back now that we live in Enid. So, hate that, but
so much fun.
We're gonna have a lot of fun. We're taking a new route this time, so maybe I can show you guys cool stuff. Ignore my dirty windshield and the giant crack, but I was right, there is stuff. There's buttes.
This is Gloss Mountain State Park. It is, I think, I don't even know where this is. Middle of nowhere.
Bless me. We are in the middle of nowhere, but we
have buttes.
Beauty rocking everywhere. What do you think about that?
Surf makes a lot.
Yeah, sort of.
Videos of the windmills. There's so many windmills, guys. Oh my god.
Shattuck Windmill Museum.
And a park.
Fun.
I think the park is just going through the windmills.
Contrary to popular belief, dinosaurs still exist. They're alive and well in Texas, and I'm here to show you them. What a beautiful sight.
He's so majestic.
A stegosaurus. We're at BCW. The crowd is piling through. It's gonna be a great night. Got a little Loki bear segment coming up, but we're lit. It's not that hot in Texas, but it's hot in here, you know? I got 0 friends. I thought I would show you guys something that I usually don't show on the vlog. I always show you guys the hustle and bustle, the before, the during, the fans, you know, all that interaction. But look at this. These fans are sloppy. Can you believe this?
And then you listen to me.
And then you wonder why I say they're sloppy.
So, got my pay from BCW. I will remain at an undisclosed amount just for the sanctity of business. But
Best rib that I've ever been a part of is paying me my booking fee in entirely ones, as if I'm going to the strip club.
After a very fun weekend in Loveland, Texas, that is a wrap on weekend one for the month. I am going home. 850 miles, man. Didn't know it was going to be that much after the move, but we grind. All right, since we're doing a bunch of new stuff on the vlog, gonna show you guys what I do in my day-to-day as well throughout the week, because gotta find the content, you know. But I'm currently getting my protein before the gym. I'm trying this stuff for the first time. It's whey protein strawberry. But I'm gonna do two scoops of that and do like 20 ounces of skim milk. Gonna be a lot of fun, which is approximately, I don't know, probably like 5 or 6 baby group cups. Let's see how this goes.
We're just, oh yeah, pouring it up. Pouring her up. You want to make sure you really stir this shit up, or else it's gonna be real chonky, real creamy and chonky. And I don't know about you fellas, but that's not how we roll around here. Catherine now brings up a good point of, it's funny that you think that anybody using strawberry protein powder is male. And to that, I say, fuck you.
I'm sweating my ass off. Oh my God. Why are you doing this to me, PetSmart? This shit's for the birds. Literally, they're over there.
This is actually all the workout I need to be a pro wrestler. Just slinging 40-pound dog food bags for 8 hours a day. It's brutal. Two down, one more to go.
It is bright and early, September 16th. I am about to head to Squared Circle Pro in Lubbock, Texas for some tab team action. That's when you and your buddy go to the bar and drink as much as you possibly can as a duos. But no, I'm gonna be in some tag team action with Rob Boris. My dogs are currently in one-on-one competition in the yard, so, you know, there's just a whole lot of wrestling going on today. But it is about 8:30, we got a 6-hour drive. Pray for me. All right, we made it to Lubbock for Squared Circle Pro. I'm getting sweaty, I'm getting real sweaty. Can't wait to show you guys the crowd. Having a dope fatal four-way tag match, I'll let y'all know.
Hey yo, I ain't even gonna cap. TJ Slater can do that shit all day.
Yeah, twice.
He can do that twice on Sundays too. That's the funniest one. Nate looking long as fuck today. God damn. The Slim Reaper.
He getting fucked up. Sam, he getting fucked up. He getting so fucked up right now. He gonna die. He gonna die. Oh shit.
Speed.
10 o'clock at night. 10 and a half o'clock at night.
Uh-huh.
We still have people in here. Like, let me express to y'all how over this show is.
She's over.
The show's done. The show's over with. we still got this big ass steel cage up on the ring. It's insane. I'm trying to go to bed at a reasonable time. After a very long first half of the month, we are finally at the end of the newest edition of the Spotlight Sessions. I'm still going to include what I thought was super cool or what I liked from wrestling these past this past week or past 2 weeks. I think I already did one for last week, but if I haven't, my bad. Something that I liked a lot from wrestling this week was not only the fact that The Rock came back on SmackDown. I feel like nobody is talking about that at all. I'm like super hyped, but maybe that's just like little kid me, who knows. But I don't know, something that made me appreciate wrestling a lot more is like the drives. Just once again, I say it's a hassle, I say it's you know, exhausting. It is, but it's also a lot of fun because I know I'm getting to go do what I love and I get to see my friends. And Squared Circle Pro this past weekend was off the hook. Oklahoma friends, Texas friends, it was great. So I hope you guys enjoyed the newest portion of the blogs and or vlogs, and yeah, catch you for the next one.